one good thing, because today is our host is here, Dr. Nayan Tank is here, and today is his birthday. So
yes,
on behalf of the whole department and everyone, we wish him a very happy birthday.
Yes, happy birthday to Nayan.
It is good to have you, sir, here.
Thank you, thank you.
Most of the students have joined, so I welcome everyone. And without wasting much time, let's start the session. So I hand over the session to Dr. Nayan, sir. Thank you, sir.
Namaskar, Dr. Nagar sir, Dr. Ketki Ben. My pranam to both of you. Yes, it's my birthday and I want your wishes. And equally, I here see Dr. Dutia, the teachers and students. Namaskar, Suprabhat. Today, in our SDP program, I'm going to deal with two parts. First part is of compulsory English and second is for special English. So first session, approximately 20 to 30 minutes will be for compulsory, and in compulsory I have taken composition area where 30 marks are there, translation is there, reshaping of the story is there, and letter writing is there. So first I would like to focus on these areas, and then after that we will start for the main English paper number 20 I am dealing with. So from that point of view we will discuss. So first please, I would like to share slide in my compulsory. So students, please second. Yes, now this is our first topic, reshaping the story. Reshaping the story. Now generally friends, very easy topic. If we look from, just go to back to your childhood day when generally you used to listen stories, and this is the kind of story will be given, and you are supposed to make a different kind of story. See, first thing that you should read the story. Not only reading is important, but you have to focus where to twist the story. Means you have to twist. Here reshape means you are supposed to change the end of the story and develop your own story. Then you should add colors of imagination. Then you should divert the central idea of original story. Then be creative in twisting matter logically and give a new title. Now let us have an example. Generally, if we try to go back, then we had heard one story of one lion. Lion was very dangerous in the forest, and he was all animals were having a fear of lion. Everybody has no courage to raise their voice against that lion. Hello. So everybody was in tension, that's why. Please keep silence, please. So lion, the fox decided to do something. This is our original story. So fox came and fox told lion that, do you know lion, that one another lion has come in this our forest, and he is very dangerous, and he is threatening all of us, so we should do something. So lion, the real lion was in tension. Where is that lion? I want to meet him, I want to challenge him. So the fox told them, let us go. And the fox came to the one well. In that well, the fox told lion, just lion, look there. So lion looked into that well, and automatically it was his reflection in the well. Now lion was in tension. No, really. So lion started roaring. So the same reflection he got from the well. So lion thought, yes, there must be some another lion challenging me, my authority. And that's why the lion jumped into the well. And it is the time that lion was no more. Now this is real story. Now, if you are about to reset the story, the students, you must be listening. How can we reset the story? Just think over it. First, where is the twisting point? We have to find out where is the twisting point. Now, twisting point would be the lion when came to the well and when he looked into the well. This is the twisting point that he saw his reflection. Now, from here, we have to add our colors of imagination. You are free. There is no limit. You are free to use maximum imagination, maximum ideas, maximize your creativity. Then, now let us reshape it. So from the very beginning, lion and fox meeting with lion and fox brought lion to the well. Everything is up to the mark as it is. From the very twisting point, you should change the whole story. And now how will we, for example, we can give so many directions, we can give so many angles. It's free up to you. For example, let us see that lion when he saw into the well. Now what happened? Let us twist story from here. How can we twist? For example, we can add here some other direction. That lion was very smart. He was not blind follower. So he was little bit alert with what fox told him. That's why lion went to the well. Okay, up to that, okay. Then he looked into the well, but he was scientific. He was logic. So he thought that this is something not the fox said, it is a reflection of my. And that's why a lion came back and he told the fox that, dear fox, do come. And you also looked into the sea. So fox also looked. Now but natural, the same image. So lion asked the question to fox, if it is me, then what about you? You are also there. Don't make fool to people. And this way lion become very much angry to upon fox, and the lion told fox that, see, I am a lion, I am the king of this territory, so you should not make me fool. Alert, I will punish you. In this way you can have some changes in your story, and you reshape the story and give title, whatever title you like. Either you can say smart lion, or you can say techno-savvy lion, because see, in this age of technology, you can add some technological point of view also. You can add some flavor to this story. For example, you can say that fox was techno-savvy and fox used to have some digital ideas with him, and that's why fox tried to be full lion, but lion was also very much eager. He was very much knowledgeable. And he was very strong enough. He didn't believe what others say. First, he wanted to realize the thing, how it is. And then lion tried. This way also you can have different ideas in your story. It means, see, whenever you want to reshape the story, what I said that in reshaping the story, the important thing is how you twist the story. And when you are going to twist the story, for example, let us take one another story. And that is also a famous story of the crow. The crow was thirsty and he see a jug of water. But when he went there, the water was very at the bottom of the jug. So he could not sip it. And that's why, what did the crow did? Here we can have one direction. Now see, in this story, we can use our mindset, we can use our imagination, and we can make different devices to make our story more interesting. For example, see, we can say that the crow was very smart. He went to find out something and he found one straw. He came back, he entered the straw into the jug and he started sipping water. This way you can have whatever twist in your mind, but the thing, the twist should be proper, the twist should be applicable and appropriate. So that when somebody would read your story, they would feel that no, you have made proper choice, you have made proper direction, you have given proper way to your story. So this is how we can reshape our story. I think you have any confusion, then you please ask here. I think in our assignments also we had given 3 to 4 stories. So mostly you have done a lot of practices also during our college days. So Diti, Roshni, okay? Any confusion, doubts? I think no, it's good. So now I would like to jump to another point. That is letter writing. This is our second topic. Well, there are 2 kinds of letter, personal letter and official letter. And many times, whenever I teach letter writing, many times I tell students, and you must be agree with me, that either you write in Gujarati or English, your writing reveals your personality, first thing. And I say many times that whenever you write, even in NSS or in our college principal, sir, then you must have one format. Don't go whatever. See, many times you write as if you are writing in common way. Dear sir, I want this and this, I want leave, then do give me leave. But who are you? See, whenever you write, when we talk about official letter, for example, when the letter to the municipal commissioner about sanitization in your area. Because nowadays sanitization, quarantine, these words are very much popular. And sanitize. See, for example, let us say one layout. It is British English pattern, mind well. And this in British English, self-address on the right side. Self-address means your address. Who are you? For example, see, if you are writing that, see, for example, you can write that your name, your address, for example, Jubilee or near Gurukul, whatever. If you are in college, if you are writing to an official letter to a principal, then your address should be your name, for example, Aditi Dave, then TYBA, same 6. This way you can write. Then date is a must, compulsory. And date should be in proper format. Either you can write, for example, 13th May 2020, or you can write May 13, 2020. This is generally pattern of writing that. Then from the left hand side, inside address. For example, the municipal commissioner, Nagar Seva, Sadan, Rajkot, or Porbandar, whatever. A commissioner is there generally in metro city. Then your designation, salutation, sir or dear sir. This is generally famous, sir or dear sir. If you are writing to college, for example, NSS program officer, then dear sir. Or if you are writing to principal, then dear sir. This is salutation. Then subject. Salutation after subject. I forgot to mention here. Subject line. This is very important. About what you are writing. For example, our heading is sanitization in your area, means a need of sanitization. If you want leave letter, then it's a leave letter. You just mention in short. then generally it is patent. Generally, see, mind well, it is not compulsory, but generally, subject matter is divided into three paragraphs. It is one kind of format, not fixed. But generally, either you business letter or any official letter, then it should be in this way, in the very first beginning, middle, and end. In the beginning, you can write about some highlights. For example, you say that as I am living in the Jebel area, and the area is nowadays full of people are coming from outside here and there. And as you know, sir, that corona virus is spreading everywhere. In this way, you can start in the beginning. In the middle is the essence of your letter. Means you have to say the need of sanitization. Why do you want sanitization? How can sanitization be possible? In this way, you can mention. And then in the last para, once you will understand my idea, or you will understand what I want to say, and you are kindly requested to sanitize as early as possible. After all, it is a matter of public life, and you are requested to do this way. And then last, you can say yours faithfully or yours sincerely, your name. And then it should be, if you sign, then it should be with name. For example, name tag or whatever you like. So this is official letter. The format is, you just focus on format. Generally, what happens, friends? Whenever you write any letter, I have seen so many letters. When you give us your leave letter, or whenever camp is going on, then you are not able to join the camp for one day. Or if you want any leave or something, then you write. And it is without any format. You just write whatever comes in your mind. But no, this is a habit you must develop throughout your life. Whenever you go, either you go to any bank or you go to any offices, and if you are told that you give me in written, then you should write in this format. Either you should follow British English. If you want to follow American English, then everything would be on the left-hand side. Self-address would be on left-hand side, then date, then inside. Everything would be in one line, left-hand side. This is nowadays common pattern, but so far in our syllabus, we follow British English. So this is the format of British English. So you can now develop this habit. Whenever you write anything to any offices, either if you go for collector, if you go to passport office, then somebody will say that you please give me in return. Then you just write in this way, that self-address, date, inside address, salutation, subject, then subject matter, and then this. This is perfect format, and without fail, now, whenever you go, please, 100 times I tell in classroom, that please follow this format, either follow this or follow American format, but your letter should be in one specific format so that a person can recognize, and this is a reflection, or rather mirror, of your personality. Well, this is official letter, and generally you are given official letter of commissioner. In syllabus it is written municipal commissioner. Either you can have letters to DSP, SP, or collector, whatsoever. But such kind of letters may be there in examination, official letter. And second letter is, that is personal letter. Now see, this letter, for example, write a letter to your younger sister advising her to develop immunity during pandemic coronavirus. Now this is personal letter. Generally in personal letter, structure is same as seen in the last slide. That of the official letter means who are you and, but you are given freedom here. Not necessary that you should follow, because this is totally personal letter. Means here you are free to express without format, following any particular format. Here the important is given to your the development of idea. See, in official letter, you are supposed to write in limit. We are not supposed to ask officer that, hello, collector sir, how are you? He is always in good mood. whether he is okay or not, he is not supposed to answer, yes, I am fine, thank you for asking me. No. But in personal letter, we have freedom. We can talk in very informal language with our friends or relatives or our brother, sister, whatsoever, whosoever is there. Now, for example, see here, if you want to say develop immunity, then we are supposed to advise. Hello, my dear sister, how are you? Hope you are well and this and that. You are in hostel and nowadays, you know, the COVID-19 is spreading. Spreading fastest way. So this is as an elder sister or as an elder brother, this is my advice to be careful in taking. Yes. Taking care of your immunity, because if once you lose your immunity, then you will be in trouble. And then you can ask some suggestions, huh? That how to develop immunity, which kind of food you should take, which kind of personal care you should take care. This way you can say whatever you want to say. So this is in personal letter, you can have your own opinions and you are free to write. Then third one is translation. For translation, I think no need to explain, because translation is up to you. You can get meaning, you can translate it whatever way you can like. So this is a matter of practice, translation, either in English and Gujarati. So that is, I have not taken here. Only two things I have taken in compulsory. So I think letters writing and this... two letters and reshaping the story.